Can I ask Assembly Member Barry if she wants to second the motion formally now?
I would, yes, thank you, Chair.
Thank you.
And thank you to my colleague Caroline Russell for so eloquently putting forward our updated budget amendment. Since our last meeting, the crisis has moved another month on, but the problems our amendments sought to tackle remain a huge threat to the basic security of far too many Londoners. As Caroline said, this is a time of hope, but also of immense challenges. The health crisis of the pandemic might be starting to ease, but many Londoners are still looking at an uncertain future, unsure if their basic housing needs will be met. The Mayor is quite rightly looking at his budget as an opportunity to launch London's recovery, but no real recovery can go ahead when thousands of people are uncertain about where they will live. That's why the Green Amendment again contains three practical and immediate ways of easing the housing crisis. Far too many private renters are still feeling and left isolated. Standing alone, they struggle to stand up to bad landlords, to get fair tenancy terms, and to have their rights reinforced. They need proper protection and proper powers to defend themselves. They were suffering before the current crisis. Now they face dire economic uncertainties without the support they need. And this is why we proposed an amendment in January that included financial support for London's independent renters groups in the form of £1.5 million in grants. And we're proposing these grants today, again, as part of the updated amendment. The need for this help has only grown more urgent. Helping renters groups develop and grow will go a long way to developing the collective power renters need, who would otherwise have to face the housing crisis alone. And renters are not the only ones who've struggled. When I spoke to you at the last meeting discussing the Mayor's budget, we had already seen the number of homeless young people hit historic highs. Since then, homeless charity New Horizons Youth Centre has published a report showing a 20% rise in young people sleeping rough between October and December, compared with the same period in 2019. This is heartbreaking. We must recognise that we cannot push towards a brighter future while leaving a generation behind. We at City Hall must act on this. And we're making progress. I discussed with the Mayor earlier how I'm hopeful he may be about to come through, possibly with government help. But we say let's not wait for the government. Let's use money that could have sat in reserve now to fix this as soon as we possibly can. The Assembly unanimously passed a motion in December. I proposed on this. Charities, with their evidence and expertise, are calling on the GLA to back up their words with actions. And as the current Mayor would say, the good news is we're in a stronger position than we were in January to do this. Despite the struggles of coronavirus, council tax and business rates returns have come in above our earlier conservative and cautious figures. We can use some of this money to fill the gap for our young Londoners. £3 million for dedicated under 25 homeless support is double our previous proposal, but it would save us far more than twice that much in the long term. Finally, once again, the Green Amendment introduces plans to provide our incredible and indispensable key workers with nearly 2,000 new homes at rents people on average incomes can genuinely afford. Our proposal uses, in a sustainable way, £400 million from available and unspent housing grant funding to kick off a sustainable business plan that invests in buying homes to rent and then borrows to multiply the benefits. It starts with acquiring 907 homes from our existing housing stock in the city. This, the use of existing homes, is a forgotten part of the varied solutions we need to the housing crisis, and one we should be thinking about more. And in answer to Assembly Member Boff's questions earlier, the modelling for this includes a mix of one, two, and importantly, three-bedroom homes, four families, and zero penthouses. Moving on, our plan continues by using the surplus income received from charging fair London living rents for these first homes to borrow further, with the result that we can provide in just two cycles nearly 2,000 homes for these valued workers and retain a surplus. We know that key workers of all kinds have been struggling even before the crisis to live. They are part of London's recovery. I want to keep discussing this idea with you and the current Mayor. Now, the Assembly often picks up on green ideas later down the line. These ideas address urgent needs, and they come from principles we can all agree on, that recovery means not leaving a generation of young people on the back foot or on the streets. It means recognising the needs of our key workers, and it means thinking bigger than business as usual in providing homes. I recommend this amendment to the Assembly.